Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose. We will continue to explore the side effects as a part of the ongoing series. In the previous video, we basically explored the usage of remember coroutine scope. We understood that it is mainly used to trigger a coroutine which is lifecycle aware of the composable. The key term here is it is lifecycle aware and it is explicitly getting triggered by click of a button. Now let me slightly change the scenario. Instead of explicitly triggering the coroutine, which in this case is a suspend function, what if I want it to be automatically triggered when the composable loads? But keep in mind that I still want it to be lifecycle aware. That condition doesn't change. The only condition that I am changing here is it needs to get triggered automatically. In that case, I can't use the remember coroutine scope, and that is where the concept of launched effect comes into picture. So let me show you how do we do that. So let me stop now. Let me go back here. I actually don't need this particular button because now it should start automatically. So I will just remove this button as well. And then if I remove the button, I don't need the remember coroutine scope as well. So I will remove that as well. So instead, what I will do is I will write a launched effect block. This is how you write it. Launched effect. Key one is basically a parameter that is used to control how you want this launched effect to get called. Just hold on to this particular thought as of now, and we will just pass true here as of now. And then inside here, I will write start counter, and then I will call the increment counter. And since whatever that I write inside the launched effect is already under a coroutine scope, I don't need a explicit instantiation of a coroutine scope, which I was doing in the previous video. So you can see here, it already says in the suggestion by the IDE that whatever that you are writing inside this launched effect is under the coroutine scope. And just to make it very clear, let me log main activity and let me say launched effect being invoked. Let me just use the counter. So now as soon as the composable starts, this should get triggered and it should start the counter, and I should see the updated value in the UI, and I should see the same thing in the locket as well. So let me run this, and you can see that as soon as the composable launched, you are seeing the counter has got triggered. And if you go to the locket, you will see that the count is getting logged. And if I close this, the counter will stop. That basically means it automatically launched, but still it is lifecycle aware. And if you close the composable, the coroutine which had got launched with the composable is also getting stopped because the composable is getting unrendered. Now, the another question that you might be having is, where is this particular log? Let me just filter it out. The body of the launched effect got invoked only once. Now, the reason why this is happening is I have passed true to key one. So this value never changes. If it changes, it will get launched again. You can use either true, or there is another standard practice where people use unit. And in both of the cases, you will observe that the body of the launched effect only gets called once. It doesn't get called again and again. But what if you want it to be called again and again every time some value in the composable changes? That is pretty easy to handle. What we can do is, instead of passing unit, you can use counter in this case, and this you will see a different mechanism. You might be observing that launched effect is getting called again and again. Why is that? Because every time the counter changes, the launched effect gets called again. This is just for demonstration purpose. Whether you really need this kind of a scenario or not completely depends upon what you are trying to achieve. But this is how the parameter that you pass to the launched effect basically controls how many times the launched effect gets called. Does it get called once, or does it get called every time a particular state gets modified. Now the obvious next question is, why would you use a launched effect? As I told earlier, if you want to trigger a coroutine as soon as the composable loads, that is when you use the launched effect. Otherwise, remember, coroutine scope is good enough for us. And you would do this because, let's assume that as soon as the composable gets launched, you want to hit a backend using a coroutine, fetch the data, and then show it. And you don't want it to be manually triggered. This ideally should happen as soon as your composable renders. So you usually put that part of the code inside the launched effect. And not only that, if you unrender the composable, the coroutine also stops. So it is not draining the battery, and you don't have to worry about something running in the background forever, even when the composable is closed. So this is how you use launched effect. In the next video, we will continue to explore remaining side effects in Jetpack Composable. Stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.